This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To throw is Wilson. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
The 23-yard line.
Now Wilson on first down. And it's caught. Touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And his guys have made this a one-score game now.
Jake
and Mantrow talk about singing something in there. Those gloves, they help with one-handed catches, the fun stuff. Any padding for a rocket like that?
One would think so, but I'll guarantee you this. After that throw, his hands will hurt later. Not right now in the moment. He's just feeling good about catching it.
Yeah, a little stinger, but a touchdown. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
21-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And the last time that they were on the field, a little demoralizing. Missed field goal. You always feel like you want to get it in the end zone, but then, oh, well, at least we're going to get three. And the ball is knocked out, and this is picked up by the defense. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys who have to touch the ball and carry it, they're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. This one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Now a first and 10 at the 11.
Let's go, defense. Let's get off the field, defense.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the Raiders' 9-yard line.
Watch the run. Watch the run. Go, go, go. Mike 5. Watch the pass. Watch the pass.
Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Tanner Muse with it. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man to man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
That was good, tough running right first up the down, middle, and if the Raiders defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Let's go, so let's from go, inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Lock gonna throw. No escape for Locke, and he'll go down. Julian Okwara. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop it. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down.
57.
On play action, Lock. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line.
Let's go ahead and detail this situation here. Third and long coming up. Back near your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for them. You got to try and find some space for your punter because you don't want him backed up where he has to alter what he does.
On third and long, it's Lock. They'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Here's the Raiders punter now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Raiders pick it up. And the return across midfield and to the 46-yard line.
I remember sitting in special teams meetings, and at some point during the meeting, the coach would always say, you better treat this one just like you're playing offense or defense. It's a big part of the game. And we just saw evidence of why right there with that fumble.
Yeah, fumble on the punt, and after it was turning up to be a pretty decent return.
Yeah, a really nice return. They were going to be set up okay, and the offense would feel good running onto the field.
And that is caught. It's Ruggs. Touchdown, Vegas.
Henry Ruggs.
Raiders. His first touchdown on the year. And the Raiders add 6 to their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. Now a toss coming right side. It's Hines, and he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. They get the conversion, and Charles, when you only have 2 yards to go, what do you think of the toss play? Because initially it kind of sets you back a little bit.
It does, especially if you get a lot of pressure coming towards you. But if you can get to the edge, if you seal the edge with your blocking, often your tackle or your tight end on what they call the play side where the ball goes, you can get to the corner, and that allows those big guys to get out ahead of the runner.
His guys take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about,
come on, bring it,
hey,
baby, bring it.
Points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? Midfield now. Here's Wilson. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their 4th pick of the game. Instead, second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again, Wilson. Throwing deep for Galladay. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 18 yards, a big pickup there on third down.
First and 10.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top unsuccessfully.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 19. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
From the 17, Wilson. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Wilson. The Raider defense strong on that one in coverage, and now it's fourth. Good coverage there by Trayvon Mullen.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
The kick by Elliott is good. And they're hanging around here as the lead's down to 12. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
At the 25-yard line, the Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
So we come upon halftime and watch a 12-point game at the break. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. On second and 7, Wilson. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Hey, Piro,
This is Swift on the counter, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. From the shotgun, Wilson throwing deep for Galladay. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
On third down, Wilson, and he'll be stopped right at midfield.
That's good.
Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
At the 50-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first.
Another Dublin first down. First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Wilson will throw again. He'll find Swift out of the backfield. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
First and 10 at the 17-yard line.
Bring out, bring out, bring out, bring out.
Five, Mike, five.
I got it.
Five, one.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. He was looking for the Michigan Wolverine, Donovan Peoples-Jones. But it'll be second down. But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
So they went to the booth to see if that was a touchdown, and they have decided it will not be a touchdown. 6 points off the board. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. His throw caught at about the 5.
Nice.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
First and goal at the 5.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Throwing again here, Wilson. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain on the screen there. It's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing. And as a player, that means an awful lot.
He is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal.
Brings up fourth and goal.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the 1. They're going to go with a tight end here on the running play. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. T.J. Hockenson, his second touchdown on the season. And his guys are able to make this a close game again. And this time he gets it to go as it is up and good.
Raiders 21, Celtic Tigers 16.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nudge this small lead. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I'm getting a sense that the momentum of this game is changing since the break. Nice play there, and this D is fired up.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Block now to throw. Got an open man, it's Ruggs. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 16 yards, a first down.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball, let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time, they get it to him the more conventional way. And it's much more successful as well.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back now to the Emerald Isle. It's the Raiders with the lead and the football here as we get ready to start quarter number four. Play action. Reception here by Ruggs. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
First down, Las Vegas.
Stopped immediately there. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 50-yard line.
Now this time, Locke will throw. And this one is incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. You want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
From midfield, here's Locke. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And you sense the tide turning. They scored, then their defense forced the punt, and now a chance to ultimately take the lead here late. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10.
Come on, QB, come on. My five.
Wilson going to fake the give and keep it himself. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so he didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
Looking to throw on second down. Wilson. Buying time to his left. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Play action. It's Wilson. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
Here now, Johnny Townsend, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
A 39-yard punt, a return of five, and the Raiders will take over now first and 10.
At their own 27-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Right now clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than four. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
19 yards. And the Raiders.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Here's Locke to throw. This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Back to the air on second down. It's Locke. He'll look downfield for Waller. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Third and 10. Expect a timeout right away if they can't stop them here.
Hey, hey,
Lock to throw. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
Complete to Henry.
That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
But he picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Second and 12, and you'd have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming. They'll actually throw it with Locke. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Fighting through, and he's got space. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Scampering home from 19 yards out, and the Raiders add on to their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. You can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
They'll try to run with Swift. They'll try and run it here. And he is going to lose yardage here.
So the defense gets the stop. I know it's situation to situation, but who has more pressure there, offense or defense, when they go for two?
I truly believe it's the defense has more pressure because the offense has an entire playbook wide open from the two-yard line. You can run it. You can throw it. So defensively, I think most teams are going to be aggressive and force the issue and try and bring pressure.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10.
They'll run on first down.
It's Jacobs.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee, and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And he's going to let it go deep. That's going to be caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown.
Touchdown,
Henry Ruggs. with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. And oh, can you believe it? He misses another one, his third so far. So he goes back out to kick this one off. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
At their own 36-yard line.
Offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 19.
Intercepted by the Raiders. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes.
And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Henry Ruggs, the intended receiver,
and that'll bring up second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. This is Hines. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
Today's final score, Raiders.
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's...
No, but I'm on this every day.